Very exciting day. I am going to be going to visit the guys at Long Range Automotive here in Melbourne, Australia. And they are the fabricators of both our 140 litre long range main tank and also our 70 litre side sill auxiliary diesel tank. We put them in on the second build on our second Land Rover Defender, and these tanks have been amazing. We have had these things literally on rocks. They have not been damaged. They're super strong. Reason why we're going to see them is we are going to be swapping out our main long range tank, the 140 liter, for their newer version. Nothing wrong with the old one, still in absolutely good working order, but the reason we're gonna do that is because we are going to fit a rear sway bar. The original design tanks like we've got in at the moment actually clashes with where the sway bar would go on our Land Rover Defender 130. The newer versions that the guys at Long Range Automotive make have got a little cutout and extension bracket that we can put on there and still fit a rear sway bar. Reason we're fitting a rear sway bar is we're a heavy car, you know, we always get a bit of body roll. I've always been interested in if a rear sway bar would help us control that body roll on cornering. It's just a bit of a trial thing. The guys at Long Range Automotive have been absolutely awesome and are letting us come in there today, do a little bit of filming, and see how the whole process takes place. I'm pretty excited to learn a whole heap of new stuff today, so let's go. All right, I've just arrived here in Lilydale, which is in the northeast of Melbourne City. As you can see, we're here. I'm here at Long Range Automotive, very excited for the big project today. They're gonna drop the original tank out and replace it with the new one. And we've also got another very interesting project on the go, which of course these guys are more than capable of doing because they're a full fabrication store. They're building everything from scratch here. They're going to be fabricating a new rear sway bar bracket because on the installation of this original 130 tank, we had to cut that sway bar bracket off. But the new design they've got allows you to keep that bracket. But obviously we had it cut off, so the guys are actually measuring up and they're gonna replicate the bracket that was cut off in France all those years ago, re-weld it to the chassis, and we'll be good to go for the new sway bar. So it's pretty impressive. The guys have just copied it and made the exact replica out of some steel that they had here in the workshop. And that there will then hold the saddle bracket for the upper part of the sway bar. So the guys have just removed the original tank from the Defender, and I've just got the first glimpse of the brand new tank that's going in there. Pretty awesome to see the condition of the one that come out. Obviously got a lot of mud and bits and pieces on it, but as a whole, in excellent condition still.
There you go with the camel protein.
See, we've got some plastic sitting out the bottom of the...
There is probably a little portion of fuel that is above the float that we can't read because we can't get right up into the top.
Uh-huh.
But the empty, did the low fuel light still come on?
Yes.
Yeah.
So Roger has just been explaining to me the difference between the two tanks in the design, which now allows them to fit us to fit a rear sway bar to the unit. And it's quite clever, very simple, but a clever little redesign of the newer version of the long range main replacement tank for a Defender 130. I'll show you guys now. So this is our original tank that the guys have just pulled out here. And this section here is what would go underneath our rear chassis rail.
Coming over to the new tank, and as simple as that, a little cutout in that same section. So the tanks are identical, other than this little cutout section, which will allow an extension bracket to go through there and our rear sway bars to still be fitted.
The fuel gauge. So what happens when you install a long range fuel tank into your vehicle, then obviously you're changing the volume. So it's not standard anymore. So how does that affect what you see on your dashboard when it comes to the fuel tank? In our case, with the long range main replacement tank, we're getting 140 litres or just under, I think, replacement over the standard, the factory 80 litre tank. The fuel gauge just stay at full for the initial 60 litres that are extra in that tank. After that 60 litres is used up, then we see the fuel gauge come down as per normal. It doesn't make much difference at all. The fuel gauge works absolutely perfectly. I suggest never rely on your fuel gauge alone. You know, those things can fault out and they do quite regularly. Ours has been good, but know your vehicle's consumption. Every fill up, I reset my odometer to zero and keep a very close track on that.
Like when those TD5s, there's five of those lines.
Oh,
but the guys have just thrown in the new tank. It looks very nice and shiny. They've jacked it up into position, a little bit of mucking around to get it in exactly the right position, make sure all the bracket holes line up and connecting all of the sensor lines. There's the fuel gauge sensor, fuel suction line, the fuel return line. We've got our diesel heater line going in there as well, and there's a vent. So there's a little bit going on there. So with the Land Rover Defender model that we've got, the Puma model, the 2.4 liter in particular, we do not have a fuel pump in our tank. We have a high pressure fuel pump in the engine bay. So this bracket here is one of the extension bracket which allows us to fit the rear sway bar. So that will just bolt straight to the bracket already existing on our chassis. And then on the bottom side will allow us to put the saddle clamp. So the sway bar will actually go below the rear fuel tank. I haven't got the split pins, that's the only thing. It's only midday now and I arrived here at about 8 o'clock, so the boys have smashed it. I've been floating around, learning a whole heap and just watching what went on because it was super interesting. It was something that I'd never had to do, never intended to do, but just so happened to be here today and have this incredible opportunity to work together with the guys and see a diesel tank dropped out of a vehicle and installed again. Very interesting. Everything that I see someone else do for me is a massive learning curve. The diesel tank is in. The rear sway bar is fitted. Guys are just putting the tire back on now, and then I guess we're gonna lower it down and maybe see what the difference is. But as you guys know, 99% of the time, we do have that heavy camper on the back. So when we put the camper on and go for the first drive, that's when's gonna be the real test. That is job complete. I cannot thank the guys here, the entire team, for what they've done for us today. It's been an honor, a privilege to be allowed to go out the back there, see the whole job take place. These guys, they ship everywhere in the world. These tanks are phenomenal. Not often I do a bit of a speech like this about a company, big but small company and still family run and still making the stuff out the back here by hand, just a warehouse with a whole heap of cool and amazing people. Check out their website. The website is really, really cool because you can go on there, you just put your make and model and it'll tell you all of the options for the replacement main long range fuel tanks, but not only that, the auxiliary fuel tanks that they do for your vehicle, and I'm sure they've got your vehicle covered. Thanks again, guys, and we'll keep in touch. All right, big handshake for the job today. Thank you so much.
Really good to meet you today.
Oh, you too, mate. And honestly, cannot thank you enough for having me here today and letting me sort of be involved and have a look around what goes on. Because, like I've mentioned in the videos before, we've been running Long Range Automotive tanks now, two of them, for coming on 6 years. And they are absolutely incredible tanks. Today I'm here with Roger, who is, can we say co-founder?
That's right, with my brother Anthony. We started the business in 1989. Yeah, we always said that we wanted to do something together.
Mm-hmm.
And brother's a boiler maker, his background, and I'm a panel beater, smash repairs. So we borrowed some money, chucked our jobs in. Originally, we started doing stuff for, in Australia, when they convert vehicles to LPG, a lot of times they need to either modify the standard fuel tank or remove it altogether, place the LPG cylinder there, and then come up with an alternate source of petrol. So, like particularly on the old GQ Nissan Patrol, so they pull out the rear tank, put the LPG there, and then because gas has to be in the cylinder, so you're limited where you make a cylinder, but a petrol tank you can make whatever shape you like.
Of course.
So then we would make a new petrol tank forwards of the rear axle so the vehicle could still run on dual fuel.
Yeah.
And that was, I guess, what we cut our teeth on. So we then inched our way into the auxiliary market and then replacement tanks, and now that's all we do is auxiliary and replacement tanks.
Yep.
So the LPG industry is virtually
It's fizzled out a bit, hasn't it?
We then picked up on some of the exhibitions we visited, like here in Australia, we met overseas buyers. So then we established a relationship like with Outback Import, which is a company that was based in France.
Yes, so, know them very well.
So then we were doing our product into France and so through Europe, through Outback Import. We even export to China, to mainland China, because there is a lot of off-roaders enthusiasts in China. North America has also become a more, probably a newer market for us, because they have a lot of this sort of product for your big Dodge and Chevy and that sort of thing, but there's quite a good following of Toyota type four-wheel drives, and even like even just little personal imports from people all over the world over the years.
So that's that's another thing I wanted to mention. You will do a personal
import? Yes, we can. Yeah, we do. If people are happy to contact us via email, we might have a few questions. Over the years, we sort of worked out some of the models are a little bit different overseas, and if we've got that record and know what's required, we can
make a custom tank for
We can actually, we can ship it to.
That's excellent.
Yeah.
All right, fantastic. And another, when we bought this tank in France from Newman 4x4, the father of the young guy that ran the mechanic shop there, he was so excited to tell us how strong these tanks were, how tough they were. And we've put that to the test. Our auxiliary tank has got a few little battle scars on it, but absolutely no damage. Even the paint wasn't damaged. And he stressed to us that he'd had it before resting on rocks and everything. He said that's it's no issue whatsoever. So I do notice a lot of tanks now coming out in newer vehicles are made of plastic, but yours are still steel.
Yeah, so it's an aluminized steel.
Okay.
It's an aluminium coated steel.
Yep.
So that we can get the strength of steel with the corrosion resistance and aluminium. And like a plastic tank, which is rotor molded or blow molded, you're limited to the shape.
Mm-hmm.
I guess when you get into fabricating a tank, you can be a bit more geometric in the shape, so you can pick up some more litres.
Some volume in all the nooks and crannies. Awesome.
Yeah, so it's been great to meet you today and hear while we've been working away in the workshop, hear a little bit about
where
you've been here and there over the place. And,
Well, it's been an honour to take your tanks to 36 countries so far, and hopefully many more on the journeys and year ahead.
Yeah, fantastic.
And we'll keep in touch.
Good on you,
Thank you so much again, mate.
Thanks
honestly.
Cheers.
Really appreciate it.
Good.